What up, YouTube? Got a quick project I'm getting ready to do today. I'm replacing a office carpet floor mat. Here's the project. I got one of these floor mats here that sit on top of the carpet. Problem is, this guy is, I don't know if you can see it here, I've had this for, I don't know, maybe 2 years. It is cracking consistently throughout here. I took some hasty measurements to figure out how I want this thing laid out underneath my desk. Now I'm gonna show you the plan. Here's the plan. I got this sheet of 4x8 inch hard board. It's an 1/8 inch thick. I'm gonna use this as my template to put the flooring down. I'm gonna be using some extra LVP, luxury vinyl plank, that I had from one of my flip projects that I didn't use up. This is entry level LVP. It does have a little bit of a texture on top, but honestly, I think this is a good project for people who want to make one of these for their office, because you can buy super duper cheap LVP. Just get a packet or two. You're not doing a bunch of flooring from like a Lowe's or Home Depot. Or if you got a buddy who does rehab projects, just ask him for his scraps. I'm gonna lay all this stuff down as I normally would. This is a floated floor product that actually locks in on two sides, and there's tools I'll show you as I'm putting it together. But because I'm putting it down on a sheet of something that's gonna be moving around, I am gonna glue it down. That's the only variable that I have that I'm not sure how it's gonna work with gluing this stuff down, because it does have a rubber backing on it. We'll see what happens. Run it, you're locking in this side and you're locking in that side. That's why I'm running it this way. I'm gonna get all my pieces cut before I start putting down the glue, because then I can just tap them all in. When you cut a piece, you're gonna cut it somewhere in here. It's gonna leave a locking edge here, a locking edge here, and then this middle is what would be basically a dead edge. You can't use this for anything. What I do when I separate these pals is I'm separating them starting pieces. Starting pieces are the pieces that will be on this side that don't need a locking edge on the left, but need one on the right. I also have a pal of finishing pieces, which will be pieces that have a locking edge on the left, but don't have a locking edge on the right. You do that so that you can mix up where the seams are, and you're wasting the least amount of boards. You see that? Just in shipping and handling, the corner's chipped off, so the locking edge piece of this is damaged. All you're gonna do is you're gonna cut this one and use that as a starting piece, because now this locking edge is dead. So I set these aside for when I want to mix up the pattern and I need to use a piece that doesn't have a left edge because it's damaged. The way I'm doing this, my right edge is my rough edge, so they'll be jagged, and then I'll cut them all with a saw. And I want this last piece to be a full run without a seam in the middle, because it is the edge. Now that I've got the actual flooring template laid down on top of my subfloor, I am going to pick everything up in a specific order, stack it all up on the right, and then start actually laying down the glue and tapping everything to lock it in. Glue takes 12 to 24 hours for foot traffic is what they say. So I'm gonna get all this set up. I'm gonna let it dry for a couple of hours, and then I'm gonna put it off to the side and let it dry for a day. Even with the weight, these boards are sliding too much for me to lock them in. I'm actually gonna clamp these. You shouldn't really be able to feel a seam when they're locked in correctly. And I can feel a seam. sitting underweight here for over 12 hours now. Really happy with how this turned out. Really happy. Especially when you consider how cheap it was to make one of these, a custom fit for, you know, the cutouts and how I want this office set up. If you've looked on the internet or you've gone to some stores, they have those fold out wood ones, or, you know, those ones are, I want to say the cheapest one I saw was like $70. It was smaller than this, and it was just a square. I am very happy with this. Good deal. Good deal. Easy project.